Today, I'm going somewhere quite special, the Norwegian Academy of Sciences. To some, an Academy of Science is just a club for those deemed worthy by the previous members of the club. I paraphrase the famous physicist Feynman, of course, Richard Feynman.
When I became a member of the National Academy of Science, I had ultimately to resign because there was another organization, most of whose time was spent in choosing who was illustrious enough to be allowed to join us in our organization. We physicists have to stick together because there's a very good chemist that they're trying to get in, and we haven't got enough room for so. What's the matter with chemists? The whole thing was rotten.
The reason I'm going there is because one of my professors is turning 50 and he invited graduate students from the computational science program. I'm anxious to see what it's all about.
Here we are, nestled in between the French, Croatian, Russian and British embassies. Prime location, so let's venture inside, shall we?
It's already lunch here at the Academy. The format of the symposium is this sort of biographical picture show in the form of some quite accessible scientific talks, and I quite like it. So far there's been a lot about geology. Anders has kind of spearheaded computational modeling in all sorts of fields. Computational models is very useful in geological physics because the systems are usually very, very disordered, meaning that it can benefit from computational modeling or numerical approximations, like how a fracture would happen. So later this evening we'll also have a lot about brain physics and how one would simulate neurons or parts of the brain, and also a bit on how computational methods are used in education, of course. It's good fun.
Norwegian fox researcher. Here is also the famous Norwegian scientist who killed the fox and made him into a scarf.
So there you have it. That's the end of the visit to the Norwegian Academy of Science. It was not as stiff as I expected. It was a very nice informal atmosphere, and it was very interesting to learn of all the different fields that a physics professor has been acquainted with throughout the course of a career. Ta-ta for now.